So here today with Michael Ryan, who is running for County Commissioner for the 19th District. How are you today?
Good. How are you doing?
Good. Can you tell me what communities are in the 19th District?
It's all of Berkeley and about 70% of Royal Oak. It runs pretty much from 14 Mile Road to 11 Mile Road from Greenfield to Campbell.
And why have you decided to run?
There's a few things that I think we can set an example for the county and that bring people into the process so that we actually get better results rather than trying to have everything come down from on high. Two particular examples, the county has a lot of employees who have health insurance, and I'm a dentist, and I've seen how in dentistry you separate how much coverage you get based on how much choice or how much how important it is for a person to have different services. And they don't do this in medicine. They just have preventative and then everything else, which has got deductibles and copays, which is really causing a problem. So I think if we push for the county health insurance to, you know, have the county employees decide which services you have really no choice at. So maybe you got to get a gallbladder out or something like that. And then other services that you, medicine, that you have some choice about either delaying or doing something alternate, which is at a lower price. Then we can lower the cost of the county health insurance for all their employees and set that as an example for other people, other groups, other companies, even the federal government, to follow that example. And the one other example of that I'm looking at is there's this thing called civil asset forfeiture, where the prosecutor or the sheriff's department would come and say, well, you're doing some kind of crime, we're going to take your house or your bank account or your car, and you have to sue to get the money back, even if they don't prosecute you. So I would say that the county commission set a policy that the sheriff's department will not accept any money or assets from any of this kind of forfeiture unless they have gone through and had some of the spare jurors that are always, you know, extra jurors at the county courthouse, and have them decide that, yes, this is a reasonable thing, that these assets are related to the crime that we're accusing you of, and then wait until the conviction to actually dispose of the assets. If not, if people don't agree, if the jurors don't agree, then the person gets back whatever they had seized.
So you mentioned being in the dental field. Can you talk about what your professional experience has been and what skills that will bring to the commission seat?
Yes, well, first of all, yes. I had my own practice, but I've also the last 12 years worked for a classmate of mine in Detroit. So I've seen a lot of people with low income and medium income. And you have to deal with problems on a person-to-person basis. You can't just assume that the problem is, you know, oh, I'm always going to do this. You have to listen to the actual problem. If you don't have a correct diagnosis in any type of medicine, you're going to get the wrong answer anyways. So that skill is very important, especially dealing with my own practice as a fairly small practice. And also having seen we're sort of an insider-outsider. We're on the edge of the medical model of, you know, we do deal with medicine, but we also are not so engrossed with and caught up with what we're usually trained for in medical school that we can't see outside and see the bigger picture, I think.
Now, do you have any political background?
I've run for county commissioner 2 years ago. I ran for state rep mainly. I think it was the Affordable Care Act was still in its kind of early stages, and I was hoping to try to get an idea, some of these type of ideas out there about that. So other than, I've never been in elected office before though.
So you are unopposed in the Republican primary, but you will have someone on the ballot in November. Why should people vote for you?
The present county commissioner, I kind of assume that he'll come out of the primary. I got a piece, mailing piece that was directed toward my stepdaughter, and he was saying to vote him in county commissioner to fight for sick pay for all workers, to keep our water supply clean and healthy, and to keep seniors in their own homes. Well, really, the county commission doesn't have any kind of jurisdiction over this. The sick pay for all workers, that would have to be on the state level. Probably the funds to keep seniors in their own homes, either state or federal level, and the water department, you know, he could get a job there. And I think he could free up his schedule so that he could pursue his things that he wants to work on. And then I have these things that are actually related to the county commission job at hand.
If people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
My website is Ryan, the number four, oakcom.com. And I probably will try to get my email and even my cell phone. The email is 3107 Royal Oak, all one word, at sbcglobal.net.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
You're welcome. Thank you for enjoying.